Wisconsin. These are sliding in. A few of these could gently come in tonight. Best chance will be tomorrow. In the meantime, weather spies all over the place, basically straddling 80. 77 degrees at Burke, 80 at Hopkins Airport. Look at that dew point. That's nice. 47. But that has been part of the problem. We've not seen the dew points come up into the mega muggy category. Not enough moisture to squeeze out. And so the showers and the thunderstorms, well, they're pretty sparse in places. But the latest computer model showing the next run or the next batch of precip to come in may provide, some thunderstorms, enough for a half an inch. One computer model just a little more generous than that. So here we go. Forecast then for tonight, variably cloudy. Just a few random showers or a thunderstorm, 59, the overnight low. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy. This is the best chance we've had for a while of a slightly more generous amount of shower and thunderstorm activity, but it's not going to be widespread. It tapers down on Wednesday. Another batch on Thursday at 85, and then we'll cool off and dry out for the weekend. Now, so Stacy was applauding there just moments ago. She was looking at the 8-day. I assume that you were looking at Saturday and Sunday?
No, actually Monday, because the golf tournament for Cleveland Scholarships Program is Monday at Quail Hollow, and the weather looks perfect.
Mm-hmm. It does.
Yes.
Is that a plug? We'll be in good
yes,
shape.
Yes, shameless, but plug.
Good. Thanks. All right, very much. Pat Brady.
Yes, Pat, what's going on our roads?
Hi, guys. Well, it's not all that perfect, but it's pretty much business as usual. We, after came off Route 2, we came down 271, and we're continuing in the southbound direction. And the heavy traffic starts all the way up at Harvard, and it's continuing all the way down, I'm guessing, all the way to Route 8 at this point. We're just over Broadway Forbes, looking down to 480 and 14, and it is continuing down past here. Nothing in it, just a whole lot of folks that are traveling southbound at the same time. We'll switch over. We'll take a look at our Fox cam. And for those of you waiting for somebody coming outbound on the East Shoreway, things are already starting to thin out close to downtown. But right after my last report, we were coming inbound on Route 2. And from Lloyd to Lost Nation, there was a pocket of heavy traffic on Route 2. But other than that, no outstanding problems in the way of accidents or stalled cars. Bill and Stacy, back to you.
Thank you, Pat.
Here we got a baby food recall and teen sex.
Those stories and more for you in tonight's Fox Family Health Report. Gerber Foods is recalling all packages of its organic rice and oatmeal cereals. This over complaints that clumps are too large and could create a choking hazard. Gerber says a limited number of boxes contain lumps that wouldn't dissolve well in milk. Head to myfoxcleveland.com, click on business for more information on getting a refund.
Well, teenage birth rates are at a record low according to a new national survey. Researchers find fewer teens are having sex and more of them are using condoms. 47% of high school students say they've had sex compared to 54% in 91. 63% used the condom compared to only 46% in 1991. Researchers are crediting better sex education.
You knew this would happen. 8 people who shared a transatlantic flight with a contagious TB patient are now suing him. The passengers filed suit against Andrew Speaker in Canada. They are asking for $1.3 million in damages. Speaker ignored his advice from doctors and flew to Greece for his wedding and then flew back to Canada and drove across the U.S. border. One of the passengers has had a positive TB skin test, but there is no way to prove that Speaker is the source.
All right, you need to lose a little bit of weight. You might want to take up dancing. All right, Stacy, people who take up ballroom dancing say they lose weight, are fit, and have better overall outlook on life. This woman says she lost 3 dress sizes after taking some dance lessons, and that wasn't even her goal. She took up dancing just to meet some people.
It's really incredible. Everything fits better. I feel better. My posture's better. I mean, I just have had a great time doing it, too.
Nah. All right, dances like the waltz and the foxtrot improve posture, but things really get moving with the cha-cha and the salsa, which can really help you burn some calories if you want to get fit. You might want to let loose a little bit. Cut it up on the dance floor.
But you have to do it regularly. You just can't go dancing every once in a while.
Time.
Could be the biggest rummage sale in northeastern Ohio. Bargain hunters, grab your calendar. The Kiwanis Club of Lander Circle holds their big sale on Thursday morning, 10 a.m. sharp. Huge storage barns located behind Orange High School on Chagrin Boulevard, jam-packed with merchandise. This is the 50th year of the sale, so organizers are pretty good at it. And the shoppers, well, they know the routine as well.
They'll be running to get here to various buildings, you know. Some of them know where furniture is or electronics, houseware, books.
The sale runs Thursday, Friday, and Saturdays for the next 2 weeks. The proceed benefits some 36 charities in our area. The Kiwanis Club has raised over...
Kiwanis. Yes.
They raised millions over the last 50 years for charity.
All right, they did. A great time.
Yes.
People where you will be running. Our viewers going wild over Grandma's cures.
A little bit later, some of Grandma's cures that really work. Tonight, Grandma has a tip for those of you who suffer from getting gray hair.
That's right. And after the break, we're going to show off our brand new set for you here tonight. Take a look behind the scenes, a little virtual tour. We're on the jib right now, so don't go away.